Learn Excel from Mr. Excel Podcast, episode 2195. Why does my pivot table count instead of sum? Hey, welcome back to the Mr. Excel Netcast. I'm Bill Jelen. Well, every time I'm doing one of my live seminars and I create a pivot table, insert pivot table, and I check mark, let's say, customer and revenue, someone will say, whoa, wait a second. How'd you get a sum of revenue there? I always get a count. And when I hear that, I know it's one of two things. It's either that they have a couple of blank cells in their revenue column, or they are choosing, instead of one cell in the pivot table, all of the cells like this. And I get it. I know that they're doing this so they can add more data later. But you can do that, adding more data later, just by formatting this with format as table or control T. Right? So now, by adding these two blank cells in, or even one blank cell in, when I create the pivot table, insert pivot table, OK. And I choose, let's say, customer, and if I check mark revenue, well, what used to happen is revenue would fly here, but people have learned that you can't just check mark revenue. So what they do is they take the revenue and they drag it to the values area, and it becomes a count instead of a sum. All right, this has been broken for 30 years, but the last few times I did this, I was really shocked to see that it is showing up as a sum instead of a count. And so let's look at this file account. I'm of course in Office 365 and I am in version 1805. Now my laptop, which is on version 1804, has also been fixed. I went back to Ash. You remember Ash, the Wednesday tips from Ash. And I said, hey Ash, what's the story with this? This is a great improvement. This is working now. He says, yeah, someone reported it as a bug that if there's a mix of numbers and blank cells that it's getting interpreted as text. So we change that to now interpret as numbers, which is awesome. It also works if you would choose all of the column like this, which of course is now giving it what, about 400-500 numbers, two blank cells, and then a million blank cells. Even with a million blank cells, it will still correctly do the right thing. So customer and revenue, and we get a sum of revenue instead of a count of revenue. That's a beautiful thing. Now, the thing it won't do, I run into people who, instead of clearing cells by pressing the delete key like I just did, they will clear cells by typing space or space, 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 whichever. Now, that is text, and that will cause us to get a count instead of a sum. So, insert pivot table, OK. I'll choose customer. I'll choose revenue. See, revenue goes to the wrong spot. I drag it to the right spot, and I'm getting a count instead of a sum. So it has to be an empty cell, not space, 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 space. But overall, a great improvement. Now, tips like this are in my book, Mr. Excel Live, the 54 greatest tips of all time. All right, episode recap. We have been annoyed by count of revenue in pivot tables for years. It happens when you have one or more empty cells in the revenue column. Starting version 1804 of Office 365, the behavior is fixed. If it's a mix of numbers and empty cells, it will treat it as a number. You're still going to get a count if someone puts spaces instead of a number. Well, hey, I want to thank you for stopping by. We'll see you next time for another Netcast from Mr. Excel.